Welcome to my channel, and today I'm going to be doing a review on my LA Colors pressed powders. So if you're interested, stay tuned. Welcome back, and today I'm going to be doing a little review on my LA Colors pressed powders. These LA Colors pressed powders will only cost you between $1 to $1.50. That's the most I've seen them priced for. I pick up my LA Colors products and these pressed powders at my local Dollar Tree, which is awesome. I've also picked them up at my Family Dollars, Dollar General. I think I've seen them on Cherry Culture as well. I've seen them in a few different places. So if you can get your hands on these powders, I'm seriously telling you to pick them up immediately. These are my favorite powders. Now, I have them in two shades. The one you're not going to be able to see if it is nude. I've used it so much and so often that I have worn away the logo and the name. But this is what it looks like. This is the shade nude. And I'm trying not to blind you. So this is nude. As you can see, this is the lightest available shade that they offer, which is pretty great for my skin tone. It does have more of a neutral undertone to it. So I see it fitting a majority of lighter skin tones like myself. And then I also have the shade tan, which is one of the medium toned shades that they have. But I use this one as a contouring powder because, as you can see, it's a very kind of mocha shade, but it is perfect as a contour shade for my very pale skin, which normally I can't find too often without it being too shimmery or too dark. So these are nude and tan. This is tan, and then this one is the nude shade, and I'll show you the difference between them both, as you guys can see. So I will have pictures and swatches here at the end of this video just to show you guys the shades and the tones and good lighting, because this lighting's awful. But if you guys can tell, they both come in a compact type of packaging, both in black. This is the newer packaging with the half moon window, and this one is the older packaging, which is pretty simple and plain. It has a glossy matte or glossy black finish to it, but I find that they're sturdy enough. They close, snap shut. And then this one, you do get a mirror inside as well, on the other side of the window right there. So it could be used in a pinch to do your makeup if you want to travel with them. They're both sturdy enough that if you want to slip them into your makeup bag, your travel bag, they will definitely go with you. But onto the goodness inside of these. This is why I really love this powder. I have seen two different blog posts about these, maybe even a video on YouTube, about these being a dupe to the MAC MSF natural powders due to the consistency and the jobs that they do. But I will swatch it here on my finger to show you guys how creamy and smooth. Oh, it feels like butter between my fingers. Like, it honestly feels like a lotion. They're pressed really well, but not too well that they are hard. There's absolutely no fillers in these, because I know with some powders that I have, the filler is just so hard and chunky and it makes the powder awful. But both of them are so soft and smooth. And I'll swatch the tan one to show you guys. So that's tan. I love using it as a contour powder because all of my bronzers are extremely too dark to use. And the one day I saw this on clearance for 80 cents, I think it was, and I thought, wow, that looks like MAC Wedge eyeshadow. And then I heard about Emote and how Emote's a really good contour powder, so I figured I'd give it a shot, and it's amazing. It's the best powder ever. So these will make seriously the best powders in your life. Like, I use this to set my foundation, the one in nude. I use it as a blotting powder if I have oily skin for some reason, which I normally don't. I have normal to dry skin. So I bet you this will work for all skin types across the board. They can be used to set your foundation, and this keeps my liquid and cream foundation staying put and looking perfect. I love pressing it into my skin and then swirling a powder brush over it to knock off any excess. and this helps my pores look a little better. Now they don't diminish them, but it does help my larger pores kind of like go down visibly a lot, like I'll say about 50%. And also as a barrier against oils producing and oxidizing my foundation. So this definitely helps your foundation stay put. And if you need to use it for a touch me up throughout the day for your oily T-zones, this will definitely work as well. This is so much better than my Maybelline Dream Matte Powder because it has more of a natural finish to it. It's not too matte, and nor does it have any glitter or shimmer to it. It's just a perfect powder. So if you're interested in the MAC MSF, but you can never afford to pay that much for a powder, for real, these $1 powders will blow your mind away. I'm not kidding you. It's probably the best powder I've ever tried. So pick them up. I promise you guys won't be disappointed. They're amazing. And they really do have a high score on Makeup Alley. So if I haven't answered your question in this review, definitely leave it as a comment or a question down in the comment section and I will get back to you. And I hope I answered everything. So I'll see you guys on this side of the other. Bye.